Curt Young earned an impressive 6 letters while attending Arthur Hill, with much of his accolades coming on the football field, rushing for 12 touchdowns and passing for 660 yards. The quarterback had his pick of scholarships, but chose CMU because they allowed him to play both football and baseball.
I first saw him over in Midland in a tournament, and I saw him first as a hitter, hit a home run, and I took note of that, went back the next day, and he was pitching. And then I really took notice of that. Went and introduced myself to his dad, Jack, and then we've been friends and ever since.
Curt played 2 years with the Chippewa football team and 3 years with the varsity baseball team.
We won both the years he pitched. We won championships, 80 and 81. He was our, we had a great, great pitching staff in 81, maybe the best that the Chippewas have ever had. But he was the leader of that group. We always use the expression, when you needed to win the game, you gave the ball to lefty, and he got the job done.
Young worked his way through the minors before becoming a starting pitcher with the Oakland A's. In 1987, he logged 203 innings, going 13-7 with 124 strikeouts. He also pitched in the 1988 and 1990 World Series.
To have him out on the mound in the major leagues and then pitching in the World Series and winning a World Series ring makes you feel especially good.
Those who are close to Curt know that he is humble over his accomplishments, noting that he's a baseball fan first and foremost.
Autograph session got done, and they said, well, let's go down to this athletic club watering hole. All four of these guys were here. It was Mickey Stanley, Vic McAuliffe, Curt, and Mark Fidrich just walked in. And Curt says, holy cow, Mr. Elpap, there's Mark Fidrich. I said, well, yeah, you play, same sport together. And he said, well, yeah, but that's my hero. He said, Fidrich was my hero back then. He said, I got to go get his autograph. So here's Mark Fidrich giving an autograph to Curt Young. So, that tells you what type of person he is. He's still very super person.
This young left-hander, 6-6 as he starts here, his 13th game of the season.
Curt finished up with the A's in 1991, splitting time later with Kansas City and the New York Yankees. His 10-year big league career ended with 536 strikeouts.
And a wave and a miss for strike three. Curt Young picks up his second strikeout.
Right now, Curt is the pitching coach for the Class AA affiliate of the Oakland A's. It's called the Midland Rockhounds out of Midland, Texas. And one of his big students or players was Barry Zito, who's a top pitcher right now for Oakland. Kurt coached him three years ago, and he told me about him. In fact, I'll tell you, one of the top prospects right now, you heard about this Tiger trade that everybody's hollering about with Oakland and the Yankees when Jeff Weaver was gone. Well, this guy that the Tigers got, this Franklin Tremont, he was one of Kurt's top players.
And I'm really pleased that he decided to go into coaching, because he'll do such an outstanding job with young men. He, I feel, will be a major league pitching coach and maybe even a major league manager someday.
Just a good old boy from Saginaw that did very well, and very proud of him.